Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. Today, I'm going to create an accessible table in Microsoft Word that uses both English and Spanish and some graphical objects inside of a table. But before we get to that, please take a moment to hit that like and subscribe button. Now back to the video. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is launch Microsoft Word. Then to create a table, I'm going to select the Insert Table option. And we're simply going to choose a 2x8 table. And then we can begin to fill in our information. And I'm going to do something easy like best practices for accessibility. And let's go ahead and create another column to the right. And I'm gonna throw a rough translation into Google here to get best practices for accessibility in Spanish. And then we can say something like, is it the same for both languages? So I'm just literally making something up. So let's put in some best practices for accessibility in Microsoft Word. We're gonna say tables use headers, images have alternate text, document uses headings, links are properly formatted, color contrast passes, testing, and let's go ahead and delete out these two rows. All right, and I'm going to use a quick translation in Google to translate this text into Spanish. All right, I've got all of my Spanish in there. Now what I want to do is this particular option. Now what I want to do is insert a symbol into this table because I got this question from one of my subscribers who wanted to see how I would use a table with different images in it. So what I'm gonna try to do is find some icons, like a checkbox or something. Perfect, and I'm just going to copy and paste this into each of the cells. All right, so now we have a table. Now let's make the table accessible. So I'm gonna select the whole table, or you can move your cursor into the first row, and under the table design tab, I'm going to ensure that I have header row selected and deselect first column. Currently, only this top level row should be my header. I don't have the right text on the left-hand side to warrant a first column heading. Then I'm going to choose a style, and I'm pretty boring, so I'm just gonna pick a boring style. Now, we actually need to do something for the Spanish in this document. I'm going to select this column that has all of the Spanish in it, and then I'm going to select the review tab, and there's an option to set the proofing language. So I'm going to select language, and then select set proofing language. And this will allow me to pick what type of Spanish I want to enter. And for this example, I'm going to select Spanish Mexico and select okay. And if you notice, it actually removed all of the red underlines indicating that this is now Spanish in the document. So this is the correct method to tag Spanish in Microsoft Word so that it is read appropriately to a screen reader. Now let's go back to our table design. We have a table style, our header row. Let's select layout. And I want to select the option repeat header rows. And just because we're here, let's right click the table, select table properties. And under the row tab, I'm going to ensure that I have allow row to break across pages and repeat header row at the top of each page. Then under alt text, this is a gray area that a lot of people have different opinions about. Basically using a screen reader, you can't get into this description, but we're gonna throw something in here anyways because it doesn't hurt me to do it, and it seems to make everyone happy to have a description here. So I'm going to say best practices for accessibility table in English and Spanish, and then select okay. All right, let's go ahead and run the accessibility checker. I'm going to do that by selecting file, info, check for issues, check accessibility, and this document is now passing. What's interesting though is I don't remember setting alt text for these icons, so I'm going to right click the icon and select view alt text. And right now it says checkbox checked with solid fill. That's enough for me in this particular example. However, if I wanted to make this a little more accurate, I think that I would say that tables use headers is the same for both languages. I think that my table doesn't make a whole lot of sense. So maybe we can change this table header to be something else. Maybe we'll say like, user verified, this best practice has been implemented. And then what we can say is that we could write the alt text for this checkbox saying, user has verified that all tables in document use headers. And then we'll delete the rest of that. And then we can add this for our other alternate text as well. We can say, user has verified that all images in document use alternate text. And there you go. We now have a mostly accessible document. I would need to apply that alt text to the rest of these icons, but that's how you would create an accessible table in Microsoft Word using English, Spanish, and some PNG files. Thank you for watching.